Hello viewers, welcome to another episode of Banking 2.5. We are continuing with the sum, chapter 2 from Mathematics class 10, RS Agrawal, Goel Brothers Publication, ICSE Foundation. We are on sum number 6. So let us work it out. Sum number 6 says, Ahmed has a recurring deposit account in a bank. He deposits 2,500 rupees per month for 2 years, and if he gets 66,250 at the time of maturity, find the interest paid by the bank and the rate of interest. Okay, let us write down the data first of all. So we write P. So how much principal amount he is paying every month? He is paying 2,500 rupees. Right. So we'll write down P is equal to 2,500 rupees. This is episode number 2.5, and we are with sum number 6. Ahmed is paying 2,500 rupees every month, and he is paying for how many years? For 2 years. 2 years means how many months? 24 months. Okay. What else it is given? Rate of interest is given? No, rate of interest is not given, so we'll put question mark. Then SI, simple interest is given? No, simple interest is also not given, so we'll put question mark. But mature amount he is getting 66,250 rupees, that we will write. So we have got the data. Principal amount that he is paying every month for 2 years is 2,500. Rate of interest we have to find out, and the simple interest that what he is getting, that we have to find out. First of all, let us write down here simple interest formula. Simple interest is equal to P n bracket n plus 1 upon 2 multiply by 1 upon 12 multiply by R upon 100. Let us write down the formula for mature value. So mature value is equal to P n plus SI. Now if you see, this SI is equal to this SI, so I can write whole this part here, I can write whole this part here, and I can take out PN as a common. So here I can substitute the values, and I can write in this manner. So what is the mature value? 66,250 is equal to, what is principal? Principal amount is 2500 multiply by, for how many months? 24 months, plus SI. So what is SI here? SI is PN bracket N plus 1. So P is 2500 multiply by 24 multiply by 25 multiply by 1 upon 12, here it is 1, here upon 2, multiply by R upon 100. So this is the calculations that we are going to do it, right? It is just some basic knowledge that you require in order to complete this sum. Okay, so let us start from here. So what are we having? 66,250 is equal to, here we simplify, 2500 multiply by 24 plus, if you can take this one as common, so you get 1 plus, right? What you are having here, you are having here, you can, here you can cancel this one out. 25 ones are 25 fours are 12 twos are 24, and this 24 you can cancel it out. If you want, you can cancel it out. So this one becomes here 2500 multiply by 24 plus, here what you get? 2500 multiply by R upon 4. You can still cancel this one out. This one cancel, this one cancel. So it becomes 25 multiply by 25. I hope you are able to follow. It's just a simple calculation. So here 66,250 is equal to 2500 multiply by 24 plus, here you get 25, this is, this one is 25 and 25, so let me write clearly.
So 25 multiply by 25. That gives 6 125. Pen is not working properly, but I hope need to change. 625 R. Now this one goes this side, so it becomes minus. So 66250 minus. What is the calculation of this one? 6 4s are 24 4 5 25s are 100 100. Yeah, so this is how it becomes. 6 4s are 24 4 25s are 100, and these two zeros are there and 6. So you get here 60,000. So this one goes this side, so it become minus. So 60,000 is equal to here what it remains. Here it remains 625 R. We don't have space, so we are working it out here. I hope you are able to follow this one. So here 2500 multiplied by 24. So 24 I split into 6, 4s are 24. 4 25s are 100. So 100, that becomes 10,000. 10,000 multiplied by 6, it becomes 60,000. 66250 minus 60,000, that will become 6,250 is equal to 625 R. This one goes down. 6250 upon 625 is equal to R. This one cancel, it becomes 10. So R is equal to 10%. So we got the value of R. Now in we have to still, this is not over. We require to find simple interest. Our R is 10%. So we know simple interest is equal to here. If you see here, we have calculated and we have find out 25 multiplied 25, that is 625 into R. So we get 625 multiply by R. What is the value of R here? The value of R is 10. So it is 625 multiply by 10. What you will get? 625 multiply by 10, you will get 6250 rupees. This is your SI, and make a box. So here you get SI is equal to 6250 rupees, and rate of interest is 10%. I hope you understood this sum. It is pretty simple. Just a bit of basic knowledge and simple calculations are needed for doing this sum. So here, let us revise. How much amount Ahmed is paying? 2500 rupees Ahmed is paying. For how many months? 24 months. You require to find rate of interest and simple interest. Mature amount after 24 months is 66,250 rupees. So we are having SI is equal to PN bracket N plus 1 upon 2 multiply 1 upon 12 multiply R upon 100, and mature value is equal to P multiply by N plus SI. So here we are replacing the value of SI here in this SI. So we got 66,250 multiply by 2500 multiply by 24 plus. Then formula for SI is P N N plus 1 upon 2 1 upon 12 multiply by R upon 100. Calculating all these things, we got here 25 into 25 R, that is 625 R. And here you got 2500 multiplied by 24. So now if you multiply these two, you will get 60,000. But here it is equal to, we are taking this whole thing this side, so it becomes minus. So 66,250 minus 60,000 is equal to 625 R. I don't have space, so I have done here 600, and after subtracting these two, we are getting 6250 is equal to 625 R. From that 625 goes down because it is going on the other side of the equal to. So it becomes 6250 upon 625. It cancels, it becomes 10. So R is equal to 10. We still require to find out SI. SI we know from here that it is 625 R. So SI is equal to 625 R. Replacing the value of R, we got SI is equal to 6250 rupees. I hope you understood this sum. Question number 7 is also the same sort of a sum. We'll do it afterwards. Thank you very much.